so. And I think there's a problem with car 88 on the front straight.
Mate, you're supposed to come in.
No, is it out of fuel? It might be out of fuel, because I heard the call the previous lap and said you're in the next lap. So I reckon that that's what the story is.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Yeah, yeah, she's
because there's a vision low,
so the car starts, the car's shut down.
Frosty's going to cover it, and he does. There he goes. He moves right and further right and right again. He's on the white line. He's going to drop a spot in this side by side. Hold your breath, Australia.
Darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again.
We're not going to make it.
They're not going to make it. They're in the fuel pump, mate. They're in reserve.
Jade, I'm not joking. You're not going to finish if you don't get to maximum. We're talking maximum minus 100.
I don't think he can hear them. I'm sure there must be something wrong. Is his earpiece out? Paul Dumbrell can't believe it. This has continued to escalate. I haven't heard him respond, and I've got him tuned on my radio at the moment. Whincup has been told over and over and over again, back off. He has a 3-second margin. He blocks down the inside because he can. He comes to the
that was planted in my brain.
But this is the story, and that's Jamie Whincup passing the Lexus RCF safety car with the lights flashing. Can't see any green light, can't see any other additional signals, and I'll go back to the operations manual.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you.
It was a struggle here with the double stacking situation. And chose to continue on for that one lap.
He did, we didn't. He was about to come in.
Excellent driving, mate. If you use McLaughlin for a few laps now, please. Take the fuel. Nice work, mate. Keep using McLaughlin.
They've stopped on 136 down the inside. He goes, he's into the side of him. They run into
re-address
each other.
He's blocked
the outbreak. He's going to redress. He's going to redress.
But look at this. Look
at that. No, they're all gone. They're all gone. Tander's off. McLaughlin's off. The redressing's caused that.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
I don't know what to say. I just went out there and raced hard. I feel sorry for the result. Just going up to the Volvo guys and HRT guys. You don't want to see any wrecked cars, you know. So I'll just go apologise for the result, but I feel the move was on. I was in there.
That was planted in my brain, still remains within the sound of silence.
Drivers, especially Stephen Richards there to make that work. Trouble.
Wheels up.
The wheels come off the key car in that team car number one that's been closing in on the championship. What on earth has happened there?
Keep coming, mate. Keep bringing it back. Bring it back.
The hub, and it's broken a hub. It's second to third gear over the top of the hill for the blind approach. Today there's rubbish on the road everywhere. The fans have gone crazy at the top of the hill. What an off the scale car race. McLaughlin still leading with half a lap to go. McLaughlin over Van Gisbergen. He just about threw the thing away like a speedway car over the top. Van Gisbergen is barely clutching this thing.
Minimize the risk here now. This is Van Gisbergen's spot, but he's too far back. Just get it stopped. Get it stopped. Pull it up and make the apex and you're home free. Come out of here without a mistake and you're there.
He's almost done it. He's on to Conrod Straight for the last time. McLaughlin is in good shape, but now he cannot afford a mistake at the bottom, and we've seen them today. He's got the meters in hand. The I Can Quit chopper gives us the perfect view. He thinks about where he's going to break. What's he got left in store as he gets to the most critical corner in the country? Off the back of the fastest corner in the country. What a year for Team Penske. something very big.